Psycho ist komisch. Denn yep, the axe that I so gladly reported in my last glowworm update did in fact develop. I was also happy that a rarer, darker color morph was among the females. Breeding continued for a while, and near the end, even with males in excess again. And then, finally, 431 days after the first larvae of the Generation 20, I spotted the first larva of Generation 21. It hadn't even fully pigmented yet. Let's have a closer look at the whole situation. Making sure there are no larvae stuck on the lid. You see, there's a larva. There's a larva, there are larvae. Some empty eggshells. Eggs that have not developed, but there are also developed eggs mixed among them. And one more larva. Yeah, so far, so goody. I have prepared some enclosures to sort through larvae and eggs and in order to rehouse the newly hatched larvae. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, and that's number 26. Those are the older batches of eggs in an enclosure with much room in order to make sorting out the newly hatched larvae more easy. And those are the newly hatched larvae I sorted out so far. The newer batches of eggs separate. There is also one adult female still laying eggs at the moment. Yeah, you can see they have a more yellowish color to them. Nicely camouflaged against the yellow sponge cloth, and I also have currently two males in the fridge to keep them fresh for maybe later pairings. And now they go right back into the fridge. Otherwise, all that's left of Generation 20 are those three larvae. I'm not sure if they will develop. They apparently haven't eaten in a while. This is the rest of a ramshorn snail I fed them. But let's move forward and take care of Generation 21 now. I have an aquarium with many freshwater snails, an ideal food for the little babies. I will pick them up. Shouldn't have cut my nails. Really? Anyway, that's what I picked up. First feeding time. Are you excited? There you go. A bit much, but I want them all to be sated. Okay, let's see if we can witness the first bite. Yep. That one's going for it. But they are very cautious. As they should be. You can see how the larva uses its sticky tail organ in order to have some additional grip on the shell of the snail. Meanwhile, the venomous pincers are looking for a spot to inject the venom. And there's the next larva attempting to make prey. Yes, slowly but surely, all the larvae are coming to their dinner table. Nice to see. Meanwhile, I'm still adding new larvae, newly hatched ones. And the feeding continues. Now I'm also adding some crushed snails, this one and this one. They seem to like those. Up until now, I have collected 45 Generation 21 larvae so far, and they are happily feeding. I'm fairly optimistic that there will be a smooth transition from Generation 20 to 21 in my Sardinian glowworms.